looking for solutions, we came back to the U.S. and we went to New York City. And we reconnected with Giulio Bucoletti, who wrote a seminal report for the World Economic Forum. In it, he calculated that 10 years from now, the world will need 40% more fresh water than it can supply. But Giulio thinks that if more people knew about New York's water story, they could avoid that grim fate.
New York has a very particular experience, but one that I think holds the key to the solution to the water crisis for the whole world. I suspect most New Yorkers, you know, assume that water just comes out of the tap. And yet behind that tap, there is one of the most sophisticated integrations of nature and water that has ever been seen on the planet.
Giulio took us to meet the CEO of WaterAid America, Sarina Prabasi. While Sarina has worked on water issues all over the world, here in New York, she and her husband also own a coffee shop. She cares a lot about New York's water.
Water is the lifeblood of our business. Like, there is no good coffee without good water.
So you work for WaterAid, and what do you think people imagine when they think about the water crisis?
People have thought about the water crisis as something elsewhere. But now, I think there is more understanding that the water crisis is all around us.
So New York had a proverbial fork in the road, right? And had to take one option rather than the other.
In the 80s, the water was getting very polluted. Mm-hmm. And in the 90s, I think there was a real strategic decision to make of how the future of New York City water would be handled. One way could have been a bit more business as usual, invested in infrastructure.
And this was, we're talking about a treatment works, right? You know, treatment plant.
Treatment, filtration, right. Technology, high cost, I think $6 billion. Definitely a more energy intensive approach.
And what about the alternative?
And the other option was to really look at where the water is coming from.
Because where the water was coming from was the Catskill Mountains. So instead of a new treatment plant, New Yorkers chose to invest in a nature reserve that doubles as a giant water farm.
The water is being filtered by trees. This natural environment serves like a sponge, holding the water.
A forest replaces heavy industrial infrastructure with the added benefits that the place runs itself, maintenance-free, and supplies 90% of New York's water.
For New York City, it was a radical choice for the time, but it was going back to something that has been working for millennia. The water cycle belongs to nature.
In a way, it's the most simple of answers, back into nature. Find the answer back at the very beginning, from the ecosystems that we came from, and yet it can support one of the most modern societies on the planet.